Hello, class 9 student. Today, I am continuing the discussion with the chapter 3 of history, that is the Moamaria Rebellion. In the last class, we discussed about the Moamarias and also certain consequences and causes that started the rebellion. Today, we will discuss about the factors and the causes of the rebellion one by one. In this video, we will discuss about that how the change in the religious policy of Ahom has contributed the starting of the Moamaria rebellion. As I already mentioned, the rebellion did not start abruptly and in one instant. It was for the time as a consequence which started about 100 years back before the starting of the Moamaria rebellion. Here, before to understand properly, the Ahoms, they followed a different kind of religion and their chief deity was Somdev. That means they used to worship Somdev, but with the passage of time, they started attracted, they were attracted towards the Hindu religion. Why they were attracted to the Hindu religion, it is not specifically mentioned, but to it concern that Hindu religion has a rich heritage and customs and traditions that has been practiced from thousands of years. So it is because of this the Ahom royal families were attracted to this Hindu religions. Again, the Vaishnava religions which were prevailing, which was prevailing during the Ahom rule, was also at the peak. And at that time, King Jaidwas Singha, he accepted the Satradhikar. Satradhikar, that means the religious head who used to preach the religions, and we in local time it is called as Mahanta. And he accepted the Satradhikar Niranjan Dev of Auniyati Satra, we have learned that there were Satras, and among the Satras there are Moamaria Satra, and these Satras belong to Sudra, that means the lower class, but Auniyatiya Satra belong to the upper class, and the king belonging to the upper class, upper royal family, so he accepted the Satradhikar Niranjan Dev as Auniyatiya Satra. In the previous discussion, we discussed about the various Mahantas like Chaturbhuj, Vaikuntha Mahadev. So these Mahantas belong to the Moamaria Satras or the Sudra class, but Satradhikar Niranjan Dev belong to the Auniyatiya Satra, who belongs to the upper class of the Vaishnava Satra. So here, as Jaidwas Singha accepted Satradhikar of Niranjan Dev of Auniyatiya Satra as his religious preceptor, and he became the disciples of Niranjan Dev, and he displayed royal patronage towards the Bhagavati religion. This is another name of Bhagavati religion. We can say as the Vaishnava religion and Bhagavati religion is quite similar. He, being the king given as a royal patroness, how he showed the royal patroness of these Satras? He established, he donated money, established Satras in various places by donating land, property and money. That is temple. And also, in this way, the Satra tradition to the state were given to the status of the royal religion as a result. So who will be jealous of this? There began a competition among the Satras for royal patroness. This led to fighting among the various Satras as well as between the Sanghotis. Sanghotis that I have already mentioned, the classes, that is when Kal, Nika, Purush, in this way. So the Sanghotis were fighting with each other to get the royal patronage from the king. But the royal patents was obtained from the king by the higher classes, that is the Bhagavati religion or the Avniyati Sattva. During the reign of Gadadhar Singha, there was quite changes. The king understood that the Mahamarya, that is the Vaishnava Satras, were experiencing certain kind of power and positions. And these powers and positions, they started to compare with the king, with the administration. And as a result, there may be clashes in future between the Mahamaryas and the royal kingdom. So, as the fightings were going on between the Satras, the king, that is Gadadhar Singha, was compelled to take measurement to crush the power. Crush the power of these Satras. Thus, Gadadhar Singha changed the earlier political policies of the Aham, because he felt that the policy of domination towards the Satras in place of the policy of empathy that has existed for long. That means the soft-hearted feeling should not be given to the Mahamariya Satras, otherwise they will rise with their power and they will start depressing, and also they will start over controlling the other Satras, and also it will be difficult for the administration to control it. When Gadadhar Singha was in hiding as a result of displeasures of the then king, said that he was roaming in various places, and he witnesses the tradition followed inside the Satras, and he was amazed that the power and position of Satradigar, that is the Mahantas, was so high that they started to compare themselves as a parallel kingdom within the Ahom kingdom. So he felt that is why, as soon as he sat on the throne, he took steps to curtail the power of Satradigar, and the Ahom policy was changed by Gadadhar Singha, and many Satradigar ran away, fled. They fled to safer places. While many were caught and tortured unimaginable way on the king's order. But still, this policy of the Aham did not last longer. The Satradigars, many Satradigars were killed, many Satras were destroyed, many disciples were run away. But after Gadadhar Singha, his son Rudra Singha, King Rudra Singha changed the policy. The Satradigars who were exiled from the kingdom were called back, and they were installed in Majuli. Majuli, you know that it is situated between the river Brahmaputra as a river island. And here, Majuli is bounded by water bodies. And it is a confined places and better places that the king can keep a keen eye on them from his capital. And here, after installing the Vaishnava Satras, Mahamariya Satras, he again accepted the Satradigar. As I have already mentioned, the higher classes, that Avniyati Satra. At that time, who was the Satradigar of Avniyati Satra? His name was Keshavadev. As his religious preceptor, and bestow special privilege on the Brahminical Satra. Here, point to be noted that when this lower class, Sudra class of Satras were installed in the Majuli, there formed clashes between that. They thought that they were getting an ire of the Ahom administration, and they were quite satisfied with the activity of the administration. But in the meantime, when they saw the king, instead of accepting the Kalsangati or the Mahamaya Satrap as a religious preceptor, the king adopted the Aunyata Satrap, and the Satradhikar Kasavadev was termed as religious preceptor of the Ahom kingdom. They became jealous, and which this jealousy among the Sudra Satradhikars, which led to the clashes between the administration and the Mahamaryas again. In this way, the king used the policy to divide and rule. This divide and rule policy, though the British started in India during the modern history, but it was practiced before, hundreds of years before the British came to India. And this divide and rule policy were aggravated, and differences among the Brahman, and Sudra Satras can be seen. The consequence of this was seen clearly during the reign of Rudra Singha, the successor of Shiva Singha. You see, Rudra Singha was the successor of Shiva Singha. That means after Shiva Singha, reign of Rudra Singha's successor, Shiva Singha. That means Rudra Singha was the father, Rudra Singha's son. Rudra Singha was the father of Shiva Singha. And it can be said that Shiva Singha had a wife. Her name was Phuleshwari Devi. And this Phuleshwari Devi played a very important role in maintaining the religious system of Hinduism, that is Shakta cult of the Hindu caste and tradition. And in this way, that time, when the time came, the Mahamaryas were aggravated because of the policy that has been adopted by Shiva Singha and Queen Phuleshwari. So what happened during the reign of Rudra Singha? Rudra Singha invited a Brahman Pandit. His name was Krishnaram Bhattacharya. He was a Sijakta Brahman Pandit. Krishnaram Bhattacharya. And he belonged from Nadia in Bengal. Later, when Rudra Singha was invited, Rudra Singha invited Krishnaram Bhattacharya, his son Shiva Singha became a disciple of this Brahman and established him in the Nilachal Hill. And from then on, Krishnaram Bhattacharya and his successor came to be known as Parvatiya Gosai. Who was Parvatiya Gosai? Krishnaram Bhattacharya. And Krishnaram Bhattacharya was invited by Rudra Singha. And after Rudra Singha, King Shiva Singha installed him into the Nilachal Hill in Assam, and he was named as Parvatiya Gosai. It is during the reign of Shiva Singha, that is the son of Rudra Singha, Queen Phuleshwari, as I have already mentioned, known as Bor Raja, became very powerful. And at that time, Shaktism, that is the religion of Hinduism, got the opportunity to flourish during this time. The Sudra Mahanta, here the Sudra Mahanta, were repressed, or we can say as humiliated on royal orders. One example, that the disciples were tortured and forced to wear tilak. I have already mentioned that is tilak, that is put into the middle of the forehead, a kind of mark from the blood of sacrificed animals, which have also been found. And the consequence of such torture was a Mahamaryan rebellion. So this was the change, this was the cause of the change of the policy, of religious policy, before The upper classes, upper class, the higher class of the Auniyati Satra was taken as a religious perception by the king in those time, and the Sudra class were brought back from exile and installed into Majuli. And in this way, the people, the Mahamaryas, the Sudra class were repressed under the order of the Queen Phulaswari. Also the Mahanta were repressed, and to its consequence, which resulted in the Mahamari rebellion. But still it is not started. Here it becomes, this I have already mentioned as regard to disciples and the religious people. But the common man also suffered a lot in regards to the operation of the administration of the Aham kingdom. In the later class, we will discuss the next form of the causes of Mahamariya rebellion, that is the socio-economic causes. Today, I am concluding this discussion. I hope so you will share and you will understand. If you don't understand, just ask me the question. Thank you.